Welcome to It's Your Date with Destiny with Apostle Vivian and Pastor Gemma Duncan of Divine Destiny Worship Center in Diego Martin. For the next 30 minutes, join us as we take you on a journey of maximizing your potential and realizing your goals through Jesus Christ. Whether it's on a Sunday, Tuesday, or Friday, or any other day of the week, a warm welcome awaits you at Divine Destiny Worship Center, a place where your full potential is discovered. Here's a special invitation to join us.
We give God the praise. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice. You must rejoice. We will rejoice and be glad in it. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, the name of the Lord shall be praised, and it will be great. Good day, good morning, good evening, whichever time you log into this program, we are decreeing God's goodness will come running after you. Amen. As long as you give him your life. This is a good time to give God your life. Somebody who's been toying with the idea, you know, I must get saved, I must go back to church and all of that, we declare, now is your time. I'm going to anoint my hands with the anointing oil. Yes. When you come to Divine Destiny Worship Center, you can get, yes, a vial of this oil, or you have someone who you know as a friend come into Divine Destiny Worship Center as a person to get one for you. So I'm going to stretch my hands forward right now. And I declare, Lord, to that prodigal son, that prodigal daughter, that backslider, that son, daughter of a preacher, that son or daughter of an intercessor, of a member of a church, I decree this very moment you deviated and you happened on this program today, I declare, come back to Jesus. And find yourself in the house of God in the name of Jesus. Read Luke chapter 15. Meditate on that. All the lost things that were found, including the young man who went away and came back broken, but he was restored. I decree that is your situation. Amen. So I'm Apostle Vivian Duncan. On behalf of my wife, Apostle Gemma, and all the covenanters at Divine Destiny Worship Center, the House of Champions, welcoming you to this program. It's your date with destiny. Yes. And we have this song that we sing, Apostle Gemma and myself. Heal, O land, Lord, heal, O land. We are firm believers that God will heal this land of Trinidad and Tobago, or wherever you may be. That song is relevant to your nation in the name of Jesus. Receive the song. It's a prophetic word. Amen and amen.
Heal our land, Lord, heal our land. Heal our land, Lord, heal our land. On every woman, girl, boy, and man, hallelujah. Pour out your spirit, Lord, and heal our land. Heal our land, Lord, heal our land. Heal our land, Lord, heal our land. On every woman, girl, boy, and man, pour out your spirit, Lord, and heal, O land. Speak, and we will listen. Teach, and we will learn. Anoint us, and we will be empowered. Send us, and we'll go.
Speak to us, Lord, speak.
And we will listen, teach, and we will learn. Anoint us, and we will be empowered. send us, and we will go.
We will go
to the highways
and byways,
proclaiming the gospel of peace. We'll go to our next door neighbors, to the ends of the earth we will reach.
Where will we go?
We will go to the highways and the byways, proclaiming the gospel of peace. We'll go to our next door neighbors, to the ends of the earth we will reach.
Yes, O Lord.
Bless, O land, Lord, bless, O land. Bless, O land, Lord, bless, O land.
On every woman,
on every woman, billboard,
and man.
Pour out your spirit, Lord, and bless, O land.
Bless, O land, Lord.
Bless, O land, Lord, bless, O land. Bless, O land, Lord, bless, O land. On every woman, girl, boy,
and man,
pour out your spirit, Lord, and bless.
Yes, heal, O land, Lord, bless, O land, in the name of Jesus. And we want to send out a prayer as well to the people in Tobago. I'm anointing my hands. What has happened in Tobago is regrettable in terms of the politics. Hallelujah. And we know it's the politicians that run the country, that run the island, together with the business people and so on. But when the politicians are in shambles, the entire economy and the ethos, the atmosphere of the island can fall apart. So I'm standing on this word right now, that the heart of the leaders are in the hand of God. I say the heart of the leaders of Tobago are in the hands of God. There are 15 people who are in the House of Assembly. I decree you will yield to God's desire for the island of Tobago. We break that spirit of rebellion. We break that spirit of confusion, and we declare you will have the welfare of the people in the island of Tobago foremost in your mind. Come on, work together, or things will fall apart. Let it not be so. In the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. And we want to bring to you a series, yes, that we started in 2020. But because of the pandemic and so on, we never got to release it on the television. But it is so prophetic, because it embodies all of this decade of the 20s. Because every time you would call the name of the year of this decade from 2020 to 2029, you must say 2020. And when God opened it up to me, my word, 2020 will minister to you, will bring you into a place where you understand the power of God prophetically. So open up for this new series. Yes, the prophetic meaning of 20. The number 20, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Since yesterday, well, it's been happening a long time, but yesterday it became very acute. The word of God has been consuming me. about freedom of the mind, freedom of the spirit. I almost came out of my skin when I heard Sister Bridget, the prophet, who uses music, song, as a medium, a platform. She has hundreds of songs, but chose to do this song, "I'm No Longer a Slave." I don't even have to hear the other part, because that's our problem in the Caribbean. That's our problem in the Americas. That's our problem as dark-skinned people. No more plantations. But the plantation strategy still in our heads. Slavery is only legally finished. There's a document in the British Parliament that says slavery is abolished. 1834. Give them 4 more years. A moratorium for 4 years. 1838. Apprenticeship over. Slaves completely free. You know that's a falsehood. That's a lie. Because I found out that writing a bill of freedom does not necessarily liberate the people whose names are put there. Just like in the jail, they spend the 10 years there and then they sign. As they're coming out of the prison, you are free. Only to realize freedom is not something physical or even legal. It's about this. Yes. The mind. It's about what?
The mind.
The mind. Because it's the mind that generates all the energy for us to do what we have to do. That's why the Bible is very specific about how you deal with the mind. In Romans 12:1, Paul says, "Give God, I beg of you." In the Amplified, he says, "I'm going on my knees. I am appealing to you that you present your bodies as a living sacrifice." But the Amplified opens it up and says, not just the body of flesh and bones. He says, whatever is contained in there, your faculties. He said, give God that. And towards the end of it, he says, that's the most intelligent thing you can do. Not the big degree you got. Not the big job you have. Not the big position you have. He said, if you give God your decision-making machinery, your faculties, he said, then you will go on to know what is the will of God for your life. And you know what? We started it all last night saying to you, the plantation system is finished. 1834 into 1838. But the plantation effect, in fact, I dare say the ill effect is still pervasive and invasive, because none of us here was on a plantation. None. None of us here, anybody ever put chains on our hands and led us to our master. None of us here got a yoke stamped on our neck saying we belong to this plantation or that plantation. Because the legal aspect got consumed in the Emancipation Bill. But if you check it out, the strategies that they used to keep the slaves enslaved, nobody argued in the parliament for it. William Wilberforce, he didn't even think about that. He doesn't know the difference. And you know what? They gave us freedom legally. But psychologically, socially, it remains. How? So many ways. We still have the problem of how they worked on the men. Never let the man know that he had a family. And if it looked like he was finding out, discovering who his children were, they sold him to an ex-plantation. The woman whom he got pregnant was not allowed to hang with him. And it continues. I said continues. They set among us the divide and rule principle. If you keep them fighting one another, you could rule them. It continues today. When you look at who in our nation are the ones committing the murder, you will see it's black men against black men. When you look at who are leaving their children to grow up on their own, especially the boys, can't see their father. Those who are descendants of the... So yesterday I'm in Eden, in the garden, and the Lord started to talk to me, taking this whole message, this whole prophecy that he has given to us. What is the sequence, the process? He said he will use what? He will what? Fix us, then shift us, then lift us, then settle us. But herein lies the problem. The shuffling. Because I found out not everybody believes God. Not everybody believes God except it's to get some money and a house and a car. But that aspect where God says, I want to change your thinking. God, that's not convenient. Because then I cannot be who I want to be. Because once I give my mind to you, you'll control me. I don't mind you giving me the brand new Mercedes. I don't mind you giving me promotion in my job. Give me the next house. Give me 5 houses. But don't change me. Because when you change me, I'm no longer in control of myself. I want to think as rotten as I'm thinking right now. I want to treat people as I'm treating them right now. Because when they know that I could bust a cuss on them at any time, when they know I could open my mouth and cut them down with my tongue at any time, they'll know, don't mess with me. So God, if I give you my mind, what I'll give you is peace in my mind, but I'm not going to give you my mind. And that's what the plantation system has done to us. But God said to us, since Holy as Night, and since before that, that's how I developed this graphic. In 2020, which represents perfect vision, that's what all the opticians and the optometrists and all of them try to do to give you glasses to correct. Because all of us are supposed to start off with 2020. And this is 2020. Tell anybody this is 2020. Therefore, it's about vision. It's about what? Vision.
But in the Hebrew, 20 is a hand. I just put the palm here, but it's the whole hand up to the shoulder. It's a hand. Therefore, 20-20 talks about putting both hands to the task. 20-20 talks about what? But you cannot put your hand or hands to a task if you don't know what the task is. You first have to what? You first have to what? If you see it and you believe God that this is what he is showing you, and you believe he is giving you a task to bring it into existence, then you will put your effort in. Hands represent what?
Effort.
So we came up with this principle. Vision plus effort equals success. Tell anybody that for me. Makes no sense you say, I'm seeing it, and you don't bring it to pass. Makes no sense you put your hands to do a thing, but you don't know a bodo about what you're doing. But this is the season. Tell neighbor, this is the season. When God is correcting all those mistakes. And God is that strategic. How he moves us and positions us into places and into times and into seasons for specific things to be declared. You heard Premier Foy, how he's talking about how he met me and that was it. What Donald says, that kind of timing is what? Eth. It's a what? Eth. It's an eth. It's a moment in time that creates an experience that actually becomes what they call a marker as to when God begins a thing or when he brings a thing to an end.
Okay, hallelujah. You saw that logo that we had there, that graphic. God wants to, yes, he wants to fix you and lift you, and please don't shift and shuffle. Then he wants to settle you. We're going to be talking about a lot of that during this series. Amen. And as you know, yes, we have 3 adult offsprings. All of them have decided we want to be in ministry. Yes, Lord, you want us. That's what we're going to do. And we have our big son, Donnell. Yeah, Apostle Donnell Duncan and his wife, Apostle Angel Duncan. They run that church there in Atlanta, Georgia, called The Body Church, Inc.org. That's a website. Go up on that website, put your name there, and ask for the connection, the Zoom connection. Yes, or if you have friends over there or relatives in Atlanta, yes, let them log in. And it may be that the church is right next to them, so they can go physically. Amen. The Body Church, Inc.org. And they have a host of programs. Every Sunday evening at 3 p.m., you can log on, and you will get awesome word. Amen. And then we have our second son, Apostle Dion and his wife, Apostle Leah. They have started a ministry for couples, for married people, and even for those who are not married, because they are actually giving you some tips on what to do and what not to do when you get married. Yes, it's called the Marriage Confessional. You go up on their website, duncansinspire.org, and you'll be able to get their program. It's connected to YouTube as well. So go Duncan's Inspire on YouTube, the Marriage Confessional, and you will get the latest episode. In fact, all the episodes thus far. Subscribe, and whenever the latest one comes out, boom, it shows up on your phone. Amen. And then, of course, we have Dr. Jade. Yes, that's she prefers that name. She and her cousin, Prophet Simone, they have come together with other pastors' kids or children, offspring, whichever way you call it, and they have opened up a ministry for pastors' children around the world, the pkconnection.org, the pkconnection.org. You see the information coming up there. Get your pastor's son, daughter connected, and it's going to help them. I was a pastor's child as well, and it was not an easy season to live through. But God is able. Amen. And we want you to join with us at Divine Destiny Worship Center. We want you to come into the physical assembly. Join us this Sunday coming. In fact, today. Join us today, this Sunday, and be part of it. Last week was just awesome. Be with us. Amen. And we will declare the word of God for your healing. Those who will see us online, same anointing is coming your way. But it's going to be nice to be in the congregation physically. Something about the physical gathering. Bring your mask. It's still part of the law that we must have masks when we come into a religious gathering. Auditorium, as it were. Amen. So until we meet again, I'm Apostle Vivian Duncan. On behalf of my wife, Apostle Gemma, and all the covenanters at Divine Destiny Worship Center, the House of Champions, saying to you, you began life as a winner. Don't live it as a victim or die as a loser. You're a God idea. Because when God made you, he had destiny on his mind. See you at Divine Destiny Worship Center this Sunday morning. God bless you. The way you shake it is your back. It do be dull, so be dull. Now you just cut my baby. I don't be so bold. I don't be taking it. Oh baby, so free, so free. Make you know, give me better.
Reach your goals through Jesus Christ. This has been It's Your Date with Destiny, a production of Divine Destiny Media Ministry. Until next time, you began life as a winner. Don't live life as a victim or die as a loser. For when God made you, he had destiny on his mind.